So I promised. He says, "A farmer by the name of Silas F—" Then he stopped. You see, he started to tell me the truth, but when he stopped that way and begun to study and think again, I reckoned he was changing his mind. And so he was. He wouldn't trust me. He wanted to make sure of having me out of the way the whole 3 days. So pretty soon he says, "The man that bought him is named Abram Foster, Abram G. Foster, and he lives 40 mile back here in the country, on the road to Lafayette." "All right," I says, "I can walk it in 3 days, and I'll start this very afternoon."
"No, you won't. You'll start now.
And don't you lose any time about it, neither, nor do any gabbling by the way. Just keep a tight tongue in your head and move right along, and then you won't get into trouble with us. Do you hear?" That was the order I wanted, and that was the one I played for. I wanted to be left free to work my plans. "So clear out," he says, "and you can tell Mr. Foster whatever you want to. Maybe you can get him to believe that Jim is your nigger. Some idiots don't require documents. Leastwise, I've heard there's such down south here. And when you tell him the handbill and the reward's bogus, maybe he'll believe you when you explain to him what the idea was for getting him out. Go along now. Tell him anything you want to, but mind you don't work your jaw any between here and there." So I left and struck for the back country. I didn't look around, but I kind of felt like he was watching me. But I knowed I could tire him out at that. I went straight out in the country as much as a mile before I stopped. Then I doubled back through the woods towards Phelps. I reckoned I better start in on my plan straight off without fooling around, because I wanted to stop Jim's mouth till these fellows could get away. I didn't want no trouble with their kind. I'd seen all I wanted to of them, and wanted to get entirely shut of them. End of chapter 31.